سلامي على دماج ورجالها والشيخ يحيى ودار العلم يا سعد بانيها رجالا على السنة جبالا رواسم تزحزح بإذن الله تبلغ مناويها.
الدعوة السلفية في اليمن ذروتها دماج، فافهموا هذا أنتم أو غيركم. الدعوة السلفية أيضا في العالم كلها تستفيد من دماج بين مستقل ومستكثر، فافهموا هذا أنتم أو غيركم. الدعوة السلفية دين الله الحق، دين الله الحق. ألم يعني للذين آمنوا أن تخشع قلوبهم لذكر الله وما نزل من الحق.
الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله.
The Sheikh began by praising Allah. We praise Him, seek His aid and His forgiveness, and I bear witness that none has the right to be worshipped except for Allah alone, who has no partner, and I bear witness that Muhammad is His slave and His messenger.
يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون.
He quoted the ayah, which translated is, O you who believe, fear Allah as you should be feared, and do not die in a state except that you are Muslims.
يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا.
O mankind, be dutiful to your Lord, who has created you from a single person, and from him he created his wife, and from them both he created many men and women, and fear Allah, through whom you demand your mutual rights. And do not cut the relations of the womb, the kinship. Indeed, Allah is ever an all-watcher over you.
يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد.
O you who believe, fear Allah and always speak the truth. He will direct you to do righteous deeds and forgive you of your sins. And whosoever obeys Allah and His Messenger has indeed achieved a great success. To proceed.
أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدى هدى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم.
The truthest of speech is the Book of Allah, and the best guidance is the guidance of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم.
وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. أيها الناس.
And the worst of affairs are the newly invented matters in the religion, and every newly invented matter is an innovation, and every innovation is a misguidance, and every misguidance is in the hellfire. O mankind.
روى مسلم في صحيحه من حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال.
It has been reported in Sahih Muslim on the authority of Abu Huraira رضي الله عنه that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he said.
من نفس عن مسلم كربة من كرب الدنيا نفس الله عنه كربة من كرب يوم القيامة.
Whoever relieves from a Muslim a distress from the distresses of this world, Allah will relieve one of his distresses on the day of resurrection.
ومن يسر على معسر يسر الله عليه في الدنيا والآخرة.
And whoever makes things easy for the one who is in difficult circumstances, then Allah will make easy for him in this world and in the hereafter.
ومن ستر مسلما ستره الله في الدنيا والآخرة.
And whoever conceals the faults and sins of a Muslim, then Allah will conceal his faults and sins in this world and in the hereafter.
والله في عون العبد ما كان العبد في عون أخيه.
Allah will be in the aid of the slave as long as he is in the aid of his brother.
ومن سلك طريقا يلتمس فيه علما سهل الله له به طريقا إلى الجنة.
And whoever treads a path seeking knowledge therein, then Allah will make easy by way of him doing so the path to Jannah.
هذا لفظ جامع كل فقرة منه من جوامع كلم رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم. ومن ذلك ومن سلك طريقا يلتمس فيه علما سهل الله له به طريقا إلى الجنة.
And this entire hadith has a very comprehensive meaning. Each section from it carries extensive meaning expressed in few and little words by the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sallam. And from that is, and whoever treads a path seeking knowledge therein, then Allah will make easy by way of him doing so the path to Jannah.
وهذه غنيمة عظيمة في حق من يسلك طريقا يلتمس فيه علما فتسهل له طريق الجنة.
And this is a tremendous booty for the one who is treading the path to seek knowledge, as the path to Jannah will be made easy for him.
ويصير سالكا في سبيلها وطلبها. وذلك لأن العلم المشروع مرضاة لله.
And he will become someone traveling for the attainment of Jannah and for the sake of it and in pursuit of it, and all of that is due to that this prescribed knowledge is something that is pleasing to Allah.
فَمَنْ أَرْضَ اللَّهَ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمْ وَرَضُوا عَنْهُ.
So whoever pleases Allah, then Allah is pleased with them and they are pleased with him.
وَمَنْ سَلَكَ طَرِيقَ الْعِلْمِ الشَّرْعِي كَانَ فِي مَرْضَاتِ اللَّهِ.
So whosoever seeks the prescribed knowledge, which is the knowledge of the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then he will be in Allah's pleasure.
وَإِذَا رَضِيَ اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى عَنْهُ جَعَلَهُ خِيرَةَ عِبَادِهِ كَمَا يُبَيِّنُ ذَلِكَ حَدِيثُ مُعَاوِيَ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال.
And if Allah is pleased with him, then he makes him from his chosen slaves. Just as the hadith of Muawiyah رضي الله عنه makes clear that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said.
من يرد الله به خيرا يفقه في الدين. وإنما أنا قاسم والله معطي.
Whoever Allah intends good for, he gives him understanding of the deen, of the religion. And verily, I am nothing more than a distributor, while Allah, He is the bestower, the one who gives.
وَلَا تَزَالُ طَائِفَةٌ عَلَى الْحَقِّ ظَاهِرِينَ لَا يَضُرُّهُمْ مَنْ خَالَفَهُمْ وَلَا مَنْ خَذَلَهُمْ إِلَى قِيَامِ السَّاعَةِ.
And there will not cease to be a group from my ummah remaining victorious upon the haqq. They will not be harmed by them who oppose them, nor desert them in any way up until the hour is established.
فبين هذا الحديث الذي قبله وأن من سلك طريق العلم أراد الله به خيرا.
So this hadith makes clear the hadith that came before it, that the one who treads the path of knowledge, Allah intends for him good.
وفقهه في دينه.
And gives him understanding of his religion.
وجعله منصورا.
And makes him victorious.
وأعطاه من فضله. وإنما أنا قاسم والله معطي.
And gives to him from his great bounty, as he said in the hadith, and verily I am nothing more than a distributor, and Allah, He is the one who gives.
فسياق الحديث يدل على دلالات عظيمة. ومن ذلك أنه منصور.
So the context of this hadith has many great points that can be taken from it. From them is that he will be victorious.
فعلم كتاب الله وسنة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم علم هدى.
So knowledge of the book of Allah and the sunnah of the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم is knowledge of guidance.
هو الذي أرسل رسوله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله وكفى بالله شهيدا.
And he quotes the ayat which the translation is, it is he Allah who has sent his messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam with guidance and the religion of truth, al-Islam, that he may make it superior to all religions, and all sufficient is Allah as a witness.
ومن سلكه هو الحجة المنصور المؤيد من ربه عز وجل. هو المؤيد من الله.
Whoever treads it, he will be a victorious proof that is aided by his Lord. He will be aided by Allah.
وهذه الطائفة المذكورة في الحديث عند أحمد والبخاري وغيرهم هم أهل الحديث. هم أهل العلم النافع وأهل سلوك طريق الجنة.
And this group that is mentioned in the hadith, which is found in Ahmad and Bukhari and others, they are the people of hadith. They are the people of beneficial knowledge. A. Knowledge of the book and the sunnah. And the people who traverse and are treading the path to Jannah.
لأن العلم منه ما هو نافع ومنه ما لا ينفع.
Because verily knowledge, from it is that which is beneficial, and from it is that which does not benefit.
ومنه ما يرضي الله ومنه ما يغضبه.
From it is that which pleases Allah, and from it is that which angers Allah.
ومنه ما هو سلوك طريق الجنة ومنه ما هو سلوك طريق النار.
From it is that which is treading the path to Jannah, and from it is that which is treading the path to the hellfire.
صح في صحيح مسلم من حديث زيد بن أرقم أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال.
It has been authenticated in Sahih Muslim on the authority of Zayd ibn Arqam that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said,
Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min ilmin la yanfa'.
O Allah, I seek refuge in you from knowledge which has no benefit.
Wa qalbin la yakhsha.
And from a heart which has no humility and fear.
Wa nafsin la tashba' wa da'watin la yustajabu laha.
And from a soul that is not satisfied, and from a supplication that is not answered.
Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min ha'ula al-arba'.
And then the Shaykh said, O Allah, I seek refuge in you from these four.
فاستعاذ رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من علم. علم غير نافع.
So the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم sought refuge from knowledge, knowledge which has no benefit.
علم ضار.
Knowledge which is harmful.
وقد وصف الله عز وجل الكافرين بقوله يعلمون ظاهرا من الحياة الدنيا.
And verily, Allah has described the disbelievers with His statement by saying, they only know the outside appearance of the life of this world.
وهم عن الآخرة هم غافلون.
And regarding the hereafter, they are heedless of it.
يعلمون ظاهرا من الحياة الدنيا.
The Shaykh, he repeats the statement of Allah Azza wa Jalla again by saying, they only know the outside appearance of the life of this world.
فأعطاهم الله علما إلا أنه غير نافع.
So Allah indeed did give them knowledge, except that that knowledge was not beneficial.
علم لا ينتفعون به في آخرتهم.
Knowledge that they cannot benefit from in regards to the hereafter.
وإن انتفعوا به في دنياهم فوجوده كعدمه.
Even though they might benefit from it in the worldly life, them having this knowledge is as good as them not having it.
وقال الله عز وجل أولم يكن لهم آية أن يعلمه علماء بني إسرائيل.
Allah عز وجل has said in the English translation, is it not a sign to them that the learned scholars, the ulama, who embraced Islam for the children of Israel, knew it as true?
فسمّاهم الله علماء.
So Allah did name them as scholars, as ulama.
على أن منهم من ذمه الله عز وجل على وصفه بذلك الوصف.
Nevertheless, Allah still dispraised some of them who were upon that characteristic with that description.
أفتطمعون أن يؤمنوا لكم وقد كان فريق منهم يسمعون كلام الله ثم يحرفونه من بعد ما عقلوه وهم يعلمون.
The Sheikh mentioned the ayah, which translated means, do you, faithful believers, wish or desire that they will believe in your religion in spite of the fact that a party of them, meaning the Jews, used to hear the word of Allah, then they used to change it knowingly after they understood it. Allah Azza wa Jal mentioned, then they used to change it knowingly after they understood it.
وقال الله سبحانه وتعالى يا أيها الناس اعبدوا ربكم الذي خلقكم والذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون الذي جعل لكم الأرض فراشا والسماء بناء وأنزل من السماء ماء فأخرج به من الثمرات رزقا لكم فلا تجعلوا لله أندادا وأنتم تعلمون.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said in the English translation, O mankind, worship your Lord who created you and those who were before you so that you may become al-muttaqoon, those who have taqwa, who has made the earth a resting place for you and the sky as a canopy and sent down water, rain from the sky and brought forth therewith fruits as a provision for you. Then do not set up rivals to Allah in worship while you know that He alone has the right to be worshipped.
وصفهم بالعلم أنهم يعلمون أن الله لا ند له.
So Allah described them with having knowledge because they knew that Allah had no rival along with Him.
ومع ذلك لم ينفعهم هذا العلم. علم لا ينفع.
And in spite of all of this, their knowledge did not benefit them. From which was taken from the previous hadith, من علم لا ينفع. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he sought refuge in Allah from knowledge which has no benefit.
يعتبر حجة عليهم وليس لهم. كما روى مسلم في صحيحه من حديث الحارث الأشعري رضي الله عنه.
It is considered a proof and an evidence against them and not for them, not for their benefit, just as is reported in Sahih Muslim from the hadith of Al-Harith ibn Ash'ali رضي الله عنه.
أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال والقرآن حجة لك أو عليك كل الناس يغدو فبائع نفسه فمعتقها أو موبقها.
That the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, and the Quran is a proof either for you or against you. Everyone starts his day and is a vendor or a seller of his soul, either freeing it or bringing about its ruin and destruction.
إنما سلوك طريق الجنة هو في العلم الشرعي النافع في علم كتاب الله وسنة رسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Verily, the only way of treading the path to Jannah is by way of seeking to obtain beneficial knowledge, which is the knowledge of the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم.
هذا هو العلم حقا. إذا أطلق العلم, العلم هو علم كتاب الله وسنة رسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم.
This is knowledge in actuality. If knowledge is mentioned, it is applied to knowledge of the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم.
وما عدا ذلك وإن كان يسمى علما إلا أن النفع فيه إما أن يكون دنيويا وإما أن يكون علما ضارا كعلم الكلام والمنطق والفلسفة.
And everything apart from that, even though it might be called or named knowledge, except that the benefit in it therein is either going to be worldly knowledge or harmful knowledge or knowledge of how to play around with words and extract hidden meanings from them or logic or philosophy.
وما ابتلي به العقلانيون من علم الرأي أو غير ذلك.
Or that which the people of rational thinking have been put to trial with in regards to opinion-based knowledge and so forth.
أيها الناس احرصوا وفقكم الله على العلم النافع فإن الناس ينقسمون إلى قسمين في هذه الدنيا.
O mankind, may Allah give you tawfiq, the success and ability, seek and desire beneficial knowledge. For verily the people are divided into two categories in this life.
وكل القسم وكلا القسمين لا يشبع. قال عليه الصلاة والسلام كما ثبت عند الحاكم في المستدرك عن أنس رضي الله عنه.
And both of these categories are not satisfied. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said as is established in the Mustadrak of Al-Hakim on the authority of Anas رضي الله عنه.
من هو مان لا يشبعان من هوم في دنيا لا يشبع ومن هوم في علم لا يشبع وفي لفظين طالب دنيا لا يشبع طالب علم لا يشبع.
There are two types of people who have a greed and a craving that will not be satisfied. One who has a craving in regards to the worldly matters, and one who has a craving in regards to knowledge. And in another narration, one who has a craving in regards to seeking worldly matters, and one who has a craving in regards to seeking knowledge.
فصاحب النهمة في الدنيا هذا قد يشغل وقد يكتسب علما ولكنه ينهم به والنهمة هي الرغبة والحرص على الشيء.
So the one who possesses a craving for the worldly matters, he might get busy and preoccupied and could possibly acquire knowledge, but he will become engrossed in it. And the nihmah, as the Shaykh described, it is the desire and the wish for something.
يقول من هم يقال من هم في طعام وقال في الحديث إذا قضى أحدكم نهمته فليعجل إلى أهله أي حاجته ورغبته التي خرج من أجلها.
And it is said the craving or greediness for food. And it is said in the hadith that if one of you has finished dealing with his nihmah, then he should hasten back to his family. And nihmah here means his need or his desire that he went out for.
فإذن يعتبر من كان في هذه الحياة صنفان.
So therefore, whosoever is in this life is considered to be of two types.
فريق في الجنة وفريق في السعير.
Then he mentioned the ayah which translated means a party in the paradise and a party in the blazing fire.
إِنَّا هَدَيْنَاهُ السَّبِيلَ إِمَّا شَاكِرًا وَإِمَّا كَفُورًا.
And the next ayah which translated means, verily, we showed him the way, whether he is grateful or whether he is ungrateful.
سَوَاءٌ عَلَى هَذَا الْقَيْدِ أَوْ فِي الْآخِرَةِ.
It is the same whether upon this restriction, meaning into two groups, split into two groups in this dunya or in the hereafter.
وَقِلَهُمَا مَنْ هُمْ.
And both of them will become engrossed in it.
فَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ هُوَ مَنْهُومٌ فِي دُنْيَا وَعُلُومِ الدُّنْيَا.
One of them will become engrossed in the dunya and the different types of knowledge of the dunya.
وَالْإِشْغَالِ بِهَا.
And become preoccupied by it.
وَلَهُمْ طُمُوحَاتٌ فَارِغَةٌ.
And he has high ambitions, which are useless, empty, high, empty, unsuccessful, futile ambitions. All of which will come to an end at the point of his death.
ولا تنفعه يصلي ولا تنفعه يصوم ولا يزكي ولا يحج.
And his praying is not benefiting him, nor is his fasting benefiting him, nor him paying zakat or hajj.
ولا يعاشر امرأة عشرة صحيحة شرعية.
Nor him living in companionship with a woman in the correct legislated way.
ولا يعرف أحكاما في الوضوء ودونه ولا في المعتقد الصحيح والتوحيد.
Nor does he know any rulings of wudu, nor anything less in rank than that. Nor does he know the correct belief, nor tawheed.
مع أنه منهوم في علم ويقضي به وقته.
Nevertheless, he is engrossed in knowledge that he spends his time in.
ويستفرغ عمره ويسأل عنه يوم القيامة فلا يجد جوابا صحيحا.
And exhausted his duration of life doing, and he will be asked about it on the day of resurrection, and he won't find the correct answer.
إلا أن يوفقه الله للعلم النافع.
Unless that Allah gives him the tawfiq to obtain beneficial knowledge.
إذا أو قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لا تزول قدم عبد يوم القيامة حتى يسأل عن أربع.
The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, the two feet of the slave will not move on the day of resurrection until he is asked about four matters.
عن علمه ماذا عمل به.
About knowledge and what he did in regards to acting upon it.
ولا ينفع العلم ويدخر لك يوم القيامة إلا أن يكون نافعا.
Knowledge will not benefit except that it be from the beneficial knowledge, and it will be stored away for him on the day of resurrection.
كتاب وسنة وما كان من علوم ذلك.
The book and the sunnah and whatever knowledge is derived from them.
روى مسلم في صحيحه عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال إذا مات الإنسان انقطع عمله إلا من ثلاث.
It is narrated in Sahih Muslim on the authority of Abu Hurairah رضي الله عنه that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he said, when someone dies, all of their deeds will come to an end except for three.
صدقة جارية.
An ongoing charity.
أو علم ينتفع به.
Or knowledge that can be benefited from.
أو ولد صالح يدعو له.
Or a righteous son that supplicates for him.
ولا ينتفع إلا بما كان نافعا فعلا.
And it cannot be benefited from in actuality except if it is from the beneficial knowledge.
هذا هو سلوك طريق الجنة والذي سلكه أنبياء الله ورسوله.
This is the treading of the path to Jannah. And the prophets and the messengers treaded it.
ومن أجله أوذوا.
And due to it, they were harmed.
ومن أجله صبروا.
And due to it, they were patient.
ومن أجله رفعهم الله سبحانه وتعالى يرفع الله الذين آمنوا منكم والذين أوتوا العلم درجات.
And due to it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raised them in degrees. Allah says in the English translation, Allah will exalt in degree those of you who believe and those of you who have been granted knowledge, and Allah is well acquainted with what you do.
بالعلم بالنبوة بالرسالة بحمل دين الله.
By way of knowledge, by way of prophecy, by way of messengership, by carrying and bearing the deen of Allah.
وأمرهم الله عز وجل أن يطلبوا المزيد منه. قال الله سبحانه وتعالى وقل رب زدني علما.
And Allah ordered them to seek an increase in it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the English translation, and say, my Lord, increase me in knowledge.
مع ما آتاه الله عز وجل من العلم الكثير وهو أعلم من على وجه الأرض.
In spite of what Allah gave to them from a great abundance of knowledge and Him being the most knowledgeable on the face of the earth.
أعلم الخلق بالله سبحانه وتعالى ودين الله.
And being the most knowledgeable of the creation in regards to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the deen of Allah.
ومع ذلك يأمره الله بعد أن ذكر الآيات أن يطلب المزيد من العلم. علم كتاب الله المذكور في هذه السياق الآية.
And in spite of all of that, Allah ordered him that he seek an increase in knowledge. Knowledge of the book of Allah. That is what is mentioned in the text of this ayah.
هذا هو العلم النافع.
And that is what is beneficial knowledge.
في صحيح مسلم عن أبي بن كعب رضي الله عنه أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال.
In صحيح مسلم on the authority of أبي بن كعب رضي الله عنه that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he said.
أي آية معك أعظم في كتاب الله؟ من كتاب الله أعظم. قال أبي الله لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم. قال لي هناك العلم أبا المنذر.
Which ayah do you have from the book of Allah which is considered to be the greatest? So Ubay, he replied by saying Ayatul Kursi, الله لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم. So he صلى الله عليه وسلم he said to me, may knowledge be pleasant for you, O أبا منذر.
فسمى ذلك علما. القرآن علم.
So he called and named that knowledge. The Quran is knowledge.
وهكذا الحديث علم.
And likewise, so is hadith considered to be knowledge.
من حديث زيد بن أرقم، من حديث زيد بن ثابت، وابن مسعود، وعدد من الصحابة. أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال نذر الله امرأ سمع منا علما فوعاه، وفي لفظ حديثا فوعاه فأداه. كما سمعه.
From the hadith of Zayd ibn Thabit, Ibn Abbas, and a number of other companions, it's established that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam he said, "May Allah give radiance to the one who hears from us knowledge, and in another wording, the one who hears from us hadith and memorizes it and comprehends it and passes it on, just as he heard it."
فرب حامل فقه إلى من هو أفقه منه. ورب حامل علم فقه ليس بفقيه.
For it is possible that the one who is relaying or carrying this fiqh might pass it on to one who has more fiqh and understanding than him. And it could be possible that the one who is carrying this fiqh, this knowledge, has no understanding.
وقال في آخر الحديث عن زيد: من جعل الدنيا همه فرق الله عليه شمله وجعل فقره بين عينيه ولم يأتي من الدنيا إلا ما كتب له.
And he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said in another hadith on the authority of Zayd, whoever makes the dunya his worry, Allah will cause his affair to be divided and split, and place poverty in front of his eyes, and nothing will come to him from the dunya except that which was written for him.
وَمَنْ جَعَلَ الْآخِرَةَ نِيَّتَهُ جَمَعَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ شَمْلَهُ وَجَعَلَ غِنَى فِي قَلْبِهِ وَأَتَتْ الدُّنْيَا هُوَ رَاغِمَةٌ وَهِيَ رَاغِمَةٌ.
And whoever makes the akhirah, the hereafter, their intention, then Allah will cause his affair to come together and place richness within his heart, and the dunya will come to him against his will, not seeking it.
فَهَذَا الْعِلْمُ عِلْمُ رِزْقٍ مِنَ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ إِنَّمَا أَنَا قَاسِمٌ وَاللَّهُ مُعْطِي.
So this knowledge is the knowledge of provision from Allah Azza wa Jal. As was said in the hadith, verily I am nothing more than a distributor, while Allah is the one who gives.
من أعطاه الله العلم فقد أعطاه الخير كله.
Whoever Allah gives knowledge to, He has given to him good in its totality.
علم كتاب الله وسنة رسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم والعمل بذلك مجامع الخير. مجمع كل خير.
Knowledge of the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and acting in accordance to it, when these things are combined together, then this will produce every good.
خيركم من تعلم القرآن وعلمه وفي لفظ أفضلكم من تعلم القرآن وعلمه.
As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentions in the hadith, the best of you is the one who learns the Quran and then teaches it. And in another wording, the most virtuous of you is the one who learns the Quran and then teaches it.
أخرجه البخاري عن عثمان رضي الله عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Which is narrated in Bukhari from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam on the authority of Uthman رضي الله عنه.
علم كتاب الله وسنة رسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم هذا هو سبيل الجنة وهذا هو العلم النافع.
The knowledge of the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, this is the path to Jannah. And this is the beneficial knowledge.
هذا هو العلم النافع الذي زهد فيه كثير من الناس. هذا هو الإيواء إلى رب العالمين سبحانه.
It is this, the beneficial knowledge that a lot of the people have abstained from. This is how one can seek shelter in the Lord of the worlds.
في الصحيحين عن أبي واقد رضي الله عنه أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كان في مجلس. فجاء ثلاثة نفر فأحدهم ترك الحلقة وانصرف.
And it is reported in Sahih al-Bukhari and Muslim on the authority of Abu Waqid radiallahu anhu that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was in a gathering and three people arrived. One of them, he left the gathering and departed.
والآخر استحيى وجلس خلف الحلقة.
While the other one was shy and sat at the back of the gathering.
والآخر دخل في المجلس واستمع من رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم حديثه وعلمه.
While the third one entered into the sitting, the gathering, and was listening to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to his speech and his knowledge.
فَلَمَّا قَضَى رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ حَدِيثَهُ قَالَ أَلَا أُنَبِّئُكُمْ عَنِ النَّفَرِ الثَّلَاثَةِ أَمَّا أَحَدُهُمْ فَأَعْرَضَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ.
So when the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had finished his talk, he said, shall I not inform you of the three people? As for one of them, he turned away. So Allah turned away from him.
وَأَمَّا الْآخَرُ فَاسْتَحْيَ فَاسْتَحْيَ اللَّهُ مِنْهُ.
And as for the other, then he was shy, so Allah was shy from him.
وَأَمَّا الثَّالِثُ فَآوَى إِلَى اللَّهِ فَآوَاهُ اللَّهُ.
And as for the third one, then he sought shelter in Allah, so Allah gave him shelter and sheltered him.
فالحرص على مجالس علم القرآن والسنة إيواء إلى الله. من أجل ذلك.
So be keen to attend the sittings of knowledge of the Qur'an and the Sunnah, just due to it being the seeking of shelter in Allah.
وَلِأَنَّهُ سُلُكْ طَرِيقَ الْجَنَّةِ وَلِأَنَّهُ عِلْمٌ نَافِعٌ.
And because it is treading the path to Jannah, and because it is beneficial knowledge.
الْمَلَائِكَةُ عَظِّمْ ذَلِكَ الْمَجْلِسُ وَأَهْلَهُ.
The angels extol and magnify that sitting, and regard that sitting as great as well as the people within it.
تعظم العلم وتعظم أهله وطلابه.
They magnify the knowledge and regard the knowledge as great. They regard the people within it and the students as great.
فقد ثبت عند الترمذي وغيره. وساق عديدا من طرقه ابن عبد البر في جامعة أن زر بن حبيش رحل إلى صفوان بن عسال في مسألة يسأله فيها.
For verily it has been established in Tirmidhi and others, and Ibn Abd al-Barr has mentioned it, many chains and routes that he came through in his jami', that Zir ibn Hubaysh travelled to Safwan ibn Asal due to a matter that he wanted to ask him about. He made a journey to ask about a matter. So when he came to him, he asked him, "What has brought you here, O Zir?" So he replied to him by saying, "Seeking and desiring knowledge."
وزر بن حبيش تابعي مخضرم ثقة إمام.
And Zir ibn Hubaysh is a tabi'i, trustworthy, and an imam, and a mukhadram. And the mukhadram is one who experienced jahiliyyah and then embraced Islam. And he was alive at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but never saw him, but he met the companions.
قال جئت ابتغاء العلم جئت أسألك عن المسح عن الخفين.
So he replied, "I came seeking knowledge. I came to ask you about the matter concerning wiping over the two leather socks, the khuffain."
فقال صفوان رضي الله عنه سمعت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول إن الملائكة لتضع أجنحتها لطالب العلم رضا بما يطلب.
So Safwan رضي الله عنه said, "I heard the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم say, verily the angels lower their wings to the seeker of knowledge due to them being pleased with what he is seeking."
ثم أنشا يحدثها عن المسح عن الخفين وأبان له أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كان لا يغسل خف لا كان إذا أدخل خفي رجليه في خفيه لا يزعهما إلا من غائط لا يزعه من غائط ولا بول إلا من جنابه وحدثه الحديث بتمامه.
Then he started to talk about wiping over the leather socks, and he صلى الله عليه وسلم explained to him that if he entered his feet into his leather socks, he does not need to take them off while being a traveler for the period of 3 days and three nights, due to him defecating, nor urinating, nor sleeping, but rather only from being in a state of major impurity, al-janaba. Then he related the rest of the hadith in its entirety.
وَإِنَّمَا شَاهِدُنَا مِنْهُ أَنَّهُ بَشَّرَ بِخَبَرِ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهِ وَسَلَّمَ الثَّابِتْ عَنْهُ أَنَّ الْمَلَائِكَةَ تَضَعْ أَجْنِحَتَهَا لطالب العلم تواضعا وإجلالا وإكراما.
But rather, our point taken from the hadith is that he gave him the glad tidings of the news that is established from the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that the angels lower their wings out of humility and reverence and in honor for the seeker of knowledge.
لطالب العلم طالب العلم حتى وإن كان بادعا في الطلب يشمله ذلك ما دام في حلقة لا يشقى بها أهلها.
And the Shaykh stressed, for the seeker of knowledge, the seeker of knowledge, even if he's in the beginning of his seeking of knowledge, then he's included in it. As long as he's in a circle of knowledge, then those within the circle will never be unhappy.
ففي الصحيح أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال هم القوم وله غفرت قالوا يا رسول الله إنما مر رجل ليس منهم مر لحاجة قال وله غفرت هم القوم قال الله عز وجل هم القوم لا يشقى بهم جليسهم.
For it is reported in the Sahih that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam he said, "There are a people and I have forgiven them." They said, "O Messenger of Allah, he was simply just a man who was not from them, who happened to pass by them for some reason." So he replied, "I have forgiven them. Allah azza wa jal has said, 'There are a people. By no way those sitting with them will be unfortunate or unhappy.'"
هذا هو العلم النافع وهذا سلوك طريق الجنة.
This is what the beneficial knowledge is, and this is the treading of the path to Jannah.
قال الله سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه الكريم إنما يخشى الله من عباده العلماء.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in his noble book, which is translated, "It is only the ones who have knowledge from amongst his slaves that fear Allah."
هذا هو طلوع سلوك طريق الجنة الذي يورث الخشية ويجعله يعقل الأمور ويجعلها في مواضعها.
This is the treading of the path to Jannah, which will make you attain or inherit the fear of Allah and make him have understanding of the affairs and put them in their proper places and context.
يتكلم بعدل وإنصاف ويعبد الله على بصيرة ويخشى الله عز وجل ويتقيه.
And make him speak with justness and fairness and to be able to worship Allah upon clear insight and be able to fear Allah Azza wa Jal and to possess taqwa of him.
ويكون رحمة على نفسه ورحمة على أهله ورحمة على المسلمين.
And it will be a mercy upon himself and upon his family and upon the Muslimin.
قال عليه الصلاة والسلام إنما أنا رحمة مهداة.
He صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, verily I am nothing more than a mercy and one who is guided.
وهذا القرآن رحمة ومن أخذه وتأسى برسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فيه كان رحمة.
So this Quran is considered a mercy, and whoever takes it and takes the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم as a model, then it will be considered a mercy.
لقد جاءكم رسول من أنفسكم عزيز عليهم ما عنتم حريص عليكم بالمؤمنين رؤوف الرحيم.
And the Shaykh mentioned that ayat, which translated means, verily there has come to you a messenger from amongst yourselves. It grieves him that you should receive any injury or difficulty, and he is anxious over you to be rightly guided for your own benefit. And for the believers, he is full of pity, kind and merciful. This is what the guidance of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is.
يعز عليه عنة المسلمين ويحرص على نفعهم ويرحمهم.
It grieves him the difficulty the Muslims receive, and he is anxious and keen for their benefit and has mercy upon them.
ولكل مسلم برسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أسوة حسنة لا سيما من سلك نهجه وطريقه هديا.
And for every Muslim, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is an example, especially the one who treads his path and guidance.
قل هذه سبيلي أدعو إلى الله على بصيرة أنا ومن اتبعني وسبحان الله وما أنا من المشركين.
Then the Shaykh, he mentioned the ayah which translated means, say, O Muhammad, this is my way, I invite to Allah with sure knowledge, me and whosoever follows me. And glorified and exalted is Allah, and I am not of the mushrikun, those who worship along others with Allah.
تريد نورا في هذه الدنيا تستضيء به في ظلمات الجهل والفتن.
Do you want a light, nur, in this life, to seek to be enlightened by it in the darkness of ignorance and fitan and trials?
عليك بالقرآن والسنة فهذا هو الله النور بنص كتاب الله.
Then you must hold tight to the Quran and Sunnah, because by Allah this is light, by the text from the Book of Allah.
ومن أصدق من الله حديثا يا أيها الناس قد جاءكم برهان من ربكم وأنزلنا إليكم نورا مبينا.
And the Shaykh, he mentioned the ayat which translated means, and who is truer in statement than Allah? O mankind, verily there has come to you a convincing proof from your Lord, and we have sent down to you a manifest light.
عجبا ممن تراهم في الساحة مع القوانين ومع من الجهالات والضياع والفرار يطفئون النور ويمشون في الظلمات ويريدون الخلاص إلى بر الأمان.
It's amazing from what you see in the world today in the society, and they have with them their statues and their codes and their laws and everything else from ignorances and ruin and spare time and leisure, and they extinguish the light and choose to walk in darkness. And they just want to forget all of that, and they say, "Khalas, we've had enough of this. Let's just go forward." So take this light and seek to be enlightened by it. And you will be able to escape from fitan, from trials.
كل من أخذ كتاب الله وسنة رسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم يكون قد عمل صالحا ويكون عرض نفسه للسعادة في الدنيا والآخرة والأمن والأمان.
Everyone who takes the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he will be one who is working a righteous deed and has exposed himself to happiness in this world and in the hereafter and safety and security.
من عمل صالحا من ذكر وأنثى وهو مؤمن فلنحيينه حياة طيبة ولنجزينهم أجرهم بأحسن ما كانوا يعملون.
And the Shaykh mentioned the ayat which the translation is, whoever works righteousness, whether male or female, while he or she is a true believer, verily to him we will give a good life. And we shall pay them certainly a reward in proportion to the best of what they used to do.
وَاللَّهِ لَالثَّوَرَاتِ تُنْجِيكُمْ
The Shaykh said, By Allah, it will not be by way of revolting or revolution that will save you.
وَاللَّهِ لَالقُوَّةِ أَيْضًا الْمَادِّيَّةِ تُنْجِيكُمْ وَلَالْأَمْوَالِ
Nor will your materialistic strength save you. Nor will your wealth save you.
وَاللَّهِ لَالكَثْرَةِ تُنْجِيكُمْ وَلَالأَصْوَاتِ
By Allah, nor will your greatness in number save you, nor all the voices that you have save you.
وَاللَّهِ لَأَمْرِيكَ تُنْجِيكُمْ وَلَغَيْرُهَا
By Allah, nor will it be America nor anyone besides them that will save you.
وَاللَّهِ لَا تُفْلِحُونَ فِي هَذِهِ الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ إِلَّا بِاِسْتِفَاءَ بِهَذَا النُّورِ
By Allah, you will not be successful in this life nor in the hereafter, except by way of seeking to enlighten yourself by this light.
وَإِلَّا بِالْحَيَا بِهَذَا الرُّوحِ
Or by having light with this ruh, this revelation and mercy.
قال الله سبحانه وتعالى قد جاءكم من الله نور وكتاب مبين
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, which translated means, Indeed, there has come to you from Allah a light and a plain, clear book.
يهدي به الله من اتبع رضوانه سبل السلام
Wherewith Allah guides all those who seek His good pleasure to ways of peace.
هذا هو تريدون السلامة والنجاة وسلوك طريق الجنة
This is what we're talking about. This is it. Do you want peace, well-being, safety, security, and to be saved? To tread the path to Jannah?
بالعلم النافع سبل السلام ويخرجهم من الظلمات إلى النور بإذنه ويهديهم إلى صراط المستقيم
Then it is by way of seeking beneficial knowledge. Allah says, to ways of peace. And He brings them out of darkness by His will to light and guides them to the straight way.
إلى متى التخبط?
So how long are you going to be lost and wandering about blindly? Till when?
إلى متى التيه?
How long will you remain in deviation and error?
إلى متى الضياع?
How long are you going to remain in loss and ruin?
إلى متى الإعراض?
How long are you going to keep turning away?
والله إن بعض المسائل فيها إعراض مزري مهلك.
By Allah, there is found in some of the affairs turning away and belittlement and ridiculing, which is dangerous and will destroy someone.
إعراض شقاوة وعد الله سبحانه وتعالى أهلها بالانتقام وبالضنك.
Shunning and turning away will bring about unhappiness and wretchedness. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised those who turn away with revenge and wretchedness.
وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنْكَ وَنَحْشُرَهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَعْمَى
And the Shaykh mentioned an ayat which translated means, And whosoever turns away from my reminder, then verily for him is a life of wretchedness, and we shall raise him up blind on the day of resurrection.
قَالَ رَبِّ لِمَ حَشَرْتَنِي أَعْمَى وَقَدْ كُنْتُ بَصِيرًا
And he will say, O my Lord, why have you raised me up blind while before I had sight? And Allah will say, it is like this. Our ayat came to you, but you forgot them. You neglected them. And the Shaykh said, where are you in regards to this? Where are you in regards to the Qur'an? In many circumstances. The reading of the Qur'an is without reflection and contemplation and without acting in accordance to it except for whom Allah has mercy on. And the Shaykh, he completed the rest of the ayah where Allah says, which translated means, And so, this day, on the day of resurrection, you will be forgotten.
معيشة ضنك الآن الحال في الناس الناس في حالة معيشة ضنك
The Shaykh he said A life of hardship A wretched life This is now the condition of the people The people are living a wretched life
تعيسة مهاترات مقاتلات مصايحات مفاتن يعني في فتن في قلق في ضياع
They are miserable bickering at one another fighting with one another shouting at one another in different trials and discord and unrest and in ruin and loss
في شدة في دينهم ودنياهم
They are experiencing hardship in their deen and their dunya.
ما هو السر؟
So what is the secret behind all of this?
السر ما عملوا بكتاب الله وسنة رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم وما انتفعوا بالعلم بل إنهم تركوه جانبا وذهبوا يهرولون بعد الضياع.
The secret is that they didn't act in accordance to the book of Allah and the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم. They did not benefit from the knowledge. Rather, they left it on the side and went out chasing after destruction and ruin.
فَلْيَحْذَرِ الَّذِينَ يُخَالِفُونَ عَنْ أَمْرِهِ
And the Shaykh, he mentioned the ayah which translated means and let those who oppose the Messenger's commandment
أَمْرُهُ الَّذِي هُوَ أَمْرُهُ وَيَشْمَلْ طَرِيقَتَهُ أَنْ تُصِيبَهُمْ فِتْنَةٌ أَوْ يُصِيبَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ
And the Shaykh said, his commandment that is mentioned here in the ayah compromises and implies his method and his way. And he continued with the ayah by saying, lest some fitna should befall them or a painful torment be inflicted on them.
Alhamdulillah. Nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nastaghfiruh. Wa ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lah. Wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan 'abduhu wa rasuluh sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sallama tasliman katheera amma ba'd.
And the Shaykh said, all praise belongs to Allah. We praise Him. We seek His aid and His forgiveness. And I bear witness that none has the right to be worshipped except for Allah alone, who has no partner. And I bear witness that Muhammad is His slave and messenger. May Allah's salat and salutations be upon him and upon his family in excess. As for what follows.
علم القرآن والسنة يعتبر روحا. وكذلك أوحينا إليك روحا من أمرنا. ما كنت تدري ما الكتاب ولا الإيمان. ولكن جعلناه نورا نهدي به من نشاء من عبادنا وإنك لتهدي إلى صراط مستقيم.
Knowledge of the Qur'an and the Sunnah is considered to be a ruh, that which gives you life. And then the Shaykh, he mentioned the ayah, which translated means, and thus we have sent to you, O Muhammad, a ruh, a revelation and a mercy of our command. You knew not what is the book, nor what is faith, but we have made it the Qur'an, a light wherewith we guide whosoever of our slaves we will, and verily you, O Muhammad, are indeed guiding mankind to a straight path.
كيف تريدون أرواحا حية زكية نقية بغير الحياة وأنتم في حياة بغير القرآن.
So the Shaykh he said, how can you desire souls that are alive, pure and chaste, while you are living a life without the Quran?
فلا حياة سليمة نقية معافاة إلا بهذا الروح.
For there is no life that is sound, pure and healthy except with this Quran.
علم القرآن والسنة يعتبر هذا كرامة من الله سبحانه وتعالى وهدى.
The knowledge of the Quran and the Sunnah is considered to be this as an honor and a guidance from Allah سبحانه وتعالى.
إن هذا القرآن يهدي للتي هي أقوم.
The Shaykh he mentioned the ayah which translated means verily this Quran guides to that which is most just and right.
كيف تسير تريدون مسيرا في شيء طويل مستقيم بعيدا الفتن والقرآن عندكم مهمل إلا من رحم الله.
How can you expect to set out upon something and move along in something which is upright and correct and straight and far away from fitan and trials while the Quran on your part is neglected except for the one whom Allah bestows His mercy upon.
إن هذا القرآن يهدي للتي هي أقوم ويبشر المؤمنين الذين يعملون الصالحات أن لهم أجرا كبيرا.
And the Shaykh he mentioned the ayah which translated means verily this Quran guides to that which is most just and right and gives glad tidings to the believers who work deeds of righteousness that they shall have a great reward.
العلم النافع من أجله تبذل المهج.
It is due to beneficial knowledge that sacrifices are made.
ومن أجله تنفق الأموال.
And due to it money is spent.
ومن أجله يرحل.
And it is due to this that journeys are made.
فقد رحل موسى عليه الصلاة والسلام إلى الخضر وضرب مجمع البحرين.
For verily Musa عليه السلام he set out on a journey in search of Khadr and set out on a journey to the junction of the two seas.
ولما وصل عنده قال هل أتبعك على أن تعلمني مما علمت رشدا.
And when he reached there he said, may I follow you so that you may teach me something of that knowledge which you have been taught.
قال إنك لن تستطيع معي صبرا وكيف تصبر على ما لم تحط به خبرا قال ستجدني إن شاء الله صابرا ولا أعصي لك أمرا.
So he Khadr, he replied by saying,
Verily, you will not be able to have patience with me. And how can you have patience about a thing which you know not? So Musa, he replied by saying, If Allah wills, insha'Allah, you will find me patient, and I will not disobey you in any affair.
أدب عظيم عليه الصلاة والسلام في طلب العلم وتلقيه والرحلة.
And this is great manners that he عليه الصلاة والسلام had in the seeking of knowledge, in the way of obtaining the knowledge and then traveling out for it.
وموسى أعلم من خضر بالإجماع وأفضل منه بالإجماع ولكن عند خضر علم ليس عند موسى فرحل من أجله.
And note that Musa is more knowledgeable and more virtuous than Khadr by ijma'. The scholars do not differ in this. But verily, Khadr had some knowledge that was not found with Musa alayhi salam, and due to this, he set out on a journey to obtain it.
والقصه في سوره الكهف وعند هذه السوره عند هذه الايات الحديث حديث ابي بن كعب رضي الله عنه في بيانها وسياقتها.
And the story is found in Surah Al-Kahf in the hadith of Ubay ibn Ka'ab radiallahu anhu, which is found in the surah within these ayats clarifying this story. True knowledge in reality is beneficial knowledge, and seeking it out causes one to be treading the path to Jannah.
في الصحيحين عن أبي سعيد الخدري رضي الله عنه قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كان في من كان قبلكم رجل قتل 99 نفسا.
And it is found in Bukhari and Muslim on the authority of Abu Sa'id al-Khudri رضي الله عنه that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he said, there was a man from a nation before you who killed 99 people.
ثم سأل عن أعلم أهل الأرض فدل على راهب فأتاه فقال هل له من توبة قال ليس لا توبة له فقتله وكمل به المئة.
And then he inquired about the most learned person on the face of the earth. So he was directed to a monk. He came to him and told him that he had killed 99 people and asked him if there was any way for him to make tawbah, for him to repent and he be accepted. He replied in the negative and said no. So he killed this monk and by doing so, he killed 100 people.
ثم سأل عن أعلم أهل الأرض فدل على عالم فأتاه فقال هل له من توبة؟ قال ومن يحول بينك وبين التوبة ارحل.
He then inquired about the most learned man on the face of the earth and was directed to a scholar. He told him that he had killed 100 people and asked him if there was any way of him making tawbah and it be accepted. So the scholar replied in the affirmative and said yes and continued by saying, and what stands in the way between you and making tawbah? Leave out on a journey.
الآن هذا الآن سيسلك طريق الجنة إلى العلم يرحل من أجل العلم ارحل إلى أرض كذا فإن بها أناسا يعبدون الله فاعبد الله معه.
And now at this point he's going to start to tread the path of Jannah for knowledge. He's setting out on a journey for the reason to obtain knowledge. The scholar he said to him, lead out on a journey to such and such a land, for verily you will find in that land a people worshipping Allah, so worship Allah along with them.
يعبدون الله على بصيرة على هدى أناس خير اذهب إلى تلك البلدة تعلم واعبد الله.
And the Shaykh he commented by saying, they are worshipping Allah upon clear insight, upon knowledge, people who are upon goodness and upon all good. He told him to go to that community, learn and worship Allah.
وما أجمل هذه الفتوى.
And what a beautiful fatwa or religious verdict it was that was given to him by the scholar.
وما أنفعها لذلك الرجل.
And look how beneficial it was for that man.
حين بلغ منتصف الطريق مات واختصمت فيه ملائكة الرحمة وملائكة العذاب قالت ملائكة الرحمة إنه جاء مقبل تائبا مقبلا على ربه.
So when he reached about halfway along his journey, death had come to him. So the angels of mercy and the angels of death were disputing in regards to who was going to take him. The angels of mercy said, he has come intending tawbah with a devoted heart to Allah.
قالت ملائكة العذاب إنه لم يعمل خيرا قط.
While the angels of mercy argued by saying, verily he has never done a righteous deed in his entire life.
قال الله عز وجل أرسل ملكا يقضي بينهما أن قيسوا بين الأرضين إلى أيهما أدنى فهو له. فهو لهم. فقاسوا فوجدوه إلى أرض الخير أدنى. في رواية أنه نأى بصدره.
So Allah sent to them an angel in the form of a human being in order to judge between them. And he told them to measure the distance between the two lands, and which of the two he is closer to, then he will belong to that land. So they measured between the two lands and found him to be closer to the land of good. And in another narration, he drew closer by a slight movement on his chest.
أراد الله أنه يزحف بصدره ويميل بصدره إلى أرض الخير ببنانات بشبر أو أقل أو نحو ذلك.
Allah intended and wanted that he draw closer with his chest to the land which had good by a few finger spaces or hand spans or measurements similar to this.
ونجاه الله بهذه الرحلة العلمية وبهذه الفتوى العلمية وسلوك طريق الجنة وسار في طريق الجنة.
And Allah saved him by way of him setting out on this journey for knowledge based on this fatwa that was based on knowledge, treading the path to Jannah, and he ended up in the path to Jannah.
من سلك طريقا يلتمس فيه علما سأل الله له بطريقة إلى الجنة.
As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, whoever treads a path seeking knowledge therein, then Allah will make easy by way of him doing so the path to Jannah.
إن علم كتاب الله دلالة على الخير.
Verily, the knowledge of the book of Allah leads to all good, leads to all khair.
والدال على الخير كفاعله.
And as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said in the hadith, the one who points or leads somebody to good gets the reward as if he carried out that good himself.
من دل على هدى كان له من الأجر مثل أجر من تبعه إلى يوم القيامة لا ينقص من أجورهم شيئا.
And in another hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, whoever points someone in the direction of guidance, he gets the reward of the likes of those who follow him in that guidance up until the day of resurrection, none of their rewards being decreased in any way.
وكم ربما يوفق إنسان لدعوة واحد وتعليمه بالعلم النافع فيدعو الواحد آحاد ويدعو الآحاد مئات ويدعو المئات ألوف ويستفيد من ذلك أجورا كثيرة.
So how many is that? It's possible that a person is given tawfiq, the success and ability by Allah, that he gives dawah to one person and teaches him beneficial knowledge. Then this one person, he gives dawah to a few, and these few give dawah to a few hundred, and these few hundred give dawah to a few thousand. And he will benefit by way of this in earning numerous rewards.
وفي الصحيحين عن أبي موسى الأشعري رضي الله عنه أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال.
And in Bukhari and Muslim, on the authority of Abu Musa al-Ash'ari, radiallahu anhu, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said,
إِنَّ مَثَلَ مَا بَعَثَنِ اللَّهُ بِهِ مِنَ الْهُدَى وَالْعِلْمِ كَمَثَلِ غَيْثٍ أَصَابَ أَرْضًا فَكَانَ مِنْهَا طَائِفَةٌ طَيِّبَةٌ قَبِلَتْ الْمَاءَ فَأَنْبَتَتِ الْكَلَى وَالْعُشْبَ الْكَثِيرَ.
Verily, the likes of which Allah sent me with in regards to knowledge and guidance is the like of rain which has fallen on some ground. And there was a part of the earth which was fertile and absorbed the water and brought forth much grass and herbs.
وأمسك وأخرى أمسكت الماء نفع الله بها الناس وسقى وزرعوا الحديث.
And there was another part of the earth which held the water and Allah benefited the people thereby who drank and gave others to drink from it and used it for irrigation. To the end of the hadith.
والشاهد منه أن علم رسول الله هو العلم النافع العلم الذي جاء به رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم الكتاب والسنة.
And the point taken from it is that the knowledge of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that is the beneficial knowledge. The knowledge which the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam brought is the book and the sunnah.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, which translated means, and we have not sent you except as a mercy for the alameen, for all of the worlds.
كتاب سنة. هذا هو العلم النافع وهذا هو سبيل الجنة. وطريق الجنة لمن سلك.
The book and the sunnah. This is what is beneficial knowledge, and this is what the path to Jannah is. This is the path to Jannah for he who wants to tread it.
أيها الناس، أترون علما غير هذا تستغفر لصاحبه كل شيء حتى الحيتان في الماء؟
O mankind, do you know knowledge other than this, where even up to the fish in the sea seek forgiveness for the one who seeks it?
فإن علم كتاب الله والعلم الخير النافع لأهله علم تستغفر لصاحبه حتى الحيتان في الماء.
For verily, knowledge of the book of Allah, and it is the beneficial knowledge for the one who possesses it, it is knowledge for which even the fish in the sea seek forgiveness for the one who seeks it.
ثبت عن أبي الدرداء وأبي أمامة وجماعة من الصحابة أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال وإن العالم لتستغفر له كل شيء حتى الحيتان في الماء وحتى النملة في جحرها يصلون على معلم الناس الخير.
It has been established on the authority of Abu Darda and Abu Umama and a number of the companions that the Prophet ﷺ, he said, And verily everything seeks forgiveness for the scholar, the learned one in the religion, up to the fish in the sea, and even the ant inside its hole. They send prayers upon the one who teaches the people good.
أتعلمون علما أهله ورث رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وسائر الأنبياء غير علم الكتاب والسنة؟
Do you know any knowledge where the one who seeks it will become the inheritors of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the rest of the prophets other than knowledge of the Book of Allah and the Sunnah?
هذا هو العلم النافع.
This is what beneficial knowledge is.
قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وإن العلماء ورثة الأنبياء وإن العلماء وإن الأنبياء لم يرثوا درهما ولا دينارا إنما ورثوا العلم فمن أخذه أخذ بحظ وافر.
The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam he said, and verily the scholars are the inheritors of the prophets. For verily the prophets, they do not leave behind any dirham or dinar, but rather they only leave behind beneficial knowledge. So whoever acquires this, then they have acquired a great fortune.
ملأ يديه من الخير.
Meaning that he has filled his hands with all good.
أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يقبل بقلوب العباد بقلوبنا وقلوب سائر العباد على علم كتابه وسنة رسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم وأن يدفع عن الفتن ما ظهر منها وما بطن.
I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to turn the hearts of the slaves and all hearts and the hearts of the remainder of all the slaves to the knowledge of the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and to repel from us all fitan, all trials, that which is apparent from it and that which is hidden. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and to repel from us all fitan, all trials, that which is apparent from it and that which is hidden. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and to repel from us all fitan, all trials, that which is apparent from it and that which is hidden. And to repel from us all fitan, all trials, that which is apparent from it and that which is hidden.